Can we talk for a minute before we move on about maybe what not to do as far as your video conferencing goes? And so I'm talking about giving a full-blown lecture. If you're going to do a full-blown lecture, consider recording that and making that a video that students can watch anytime, any place. Because if it's not interactive, there's really no point in doing that in a synchronous session. What I like to do in my Zoom sessions is I like to do maybe a mini lecture, maybe 5-10 minutes tops, set the stage for the topics, introduce the agenda, and then use breakout groups. If you have that ability in your video conferencing, send students in small teams to collaborate in breakout groups to do something together and then have them come back and share out. Those are some of the things that you could do.
Yeah, exactly. And one of the things that I'd like to do, that I would do, especially in a situation like what we find ourselves in now, is I'd be going through my notes about what I plan to do in the next couple of weeks and say, you know what, this is a point here where we have a lot of discussion back and forth. This is a great thing to sort of focus in on in my Zoom session. And then this other stuff over here, this stuff is where I'm starting to talk a lot about things because there's just a lot of information that they have to have that isn't in the textbook or I need to elaborate on a lot. That part, I'm going to make a quick video and we'll go through that separately. So there's just those basic things that we can do as we go through and plan out sort of the rest of how the term is going to go.
This is
And if you feel like you're...
Go ahead.
So if you feel like you need to do a longer lecture, consider using a tool like Socrative. Socrative is, you may be familiar with like student clickers, student response systems, where during a lecture you can pause, ask a question, and the students use their devices to answer up. And so that keeps them engaged in there, and it also gives you information about where they're understanding, where their understanding's falling down, where their muddiest points are. And so that's a good tool for keeping students engaged during a longer lesson question and answer type session in video conferencing. And that it's called Socrative, but there's others. There's Kahoot, there's Pear Deck, and those are the three main ones that we work with.
Wonderful.